9 still a little bit?
Yeah, oh. Still floating in a dream.
Yes. Nothing is real yet. Nothing.
So before we get to how this actually transpired, because I think that's the interesting thing. A lot of people are like, how did he even get Dirks to do that? Lexi, did you have any idea?
No, I had no idea until Dirks himself started to pull me on stage. I thought the entire time that his boss got us these backstage passes.
Oh, okay.
And that's it. Yes, I was totally oblivious.
I was wondering what lie he told you to get you.
There was many.
Dominic, did Lexi's family and friends know, or nobody?
Yeah. So I kept it on the down low for a little bit.
Okay.
Gave him about a week advance for her family.
Okay.
So they were able to snag some VIP tickets.
Yeah, because if you tell the wrong person, it's slipping out of their mouth. Yeah. And the whole, you can't risk that. That's a lot.
Yeah, they were all going out for the 4th in Wisconsin, so I was like, I'm going to tell them after this weekend.
Yeah, get all drunk and start spilling the beans.
Yep.
Good call, Dominic. Smart move. So, Lexi, when Dirk starts to pull you on stage, what are you thinking at that point right there?
Oh, absolutely nothing. I went completely numb. Anything I was thinking at the time, I don't even remember. I just remember at the end being like, you dummy, you need to say yes. Like, get the words out of your mouth.
Right.
You need to say yes.
It was
so crazy.
It's so fun. I was standing there with my wife and we're watching it happen. And she had just got done telling me how beautiful Dirks Bentley is. And I was like, oh, I hope she's not staring. I hope Lexi pays attention to her now fiance instead of Dirks.
Eyes over here.
Right.
Yeah.
That's so funny.
So funny. All my friends made fun of me because I was paying more attention to Dom than Dirks. They're like, you didn't even look at Dirks when he was holding your hand. I'm like, I couldn't process what was going on.
Dom, how did you pull this off, man? I think that's the thing we got to know.
Yeah. It's a million-dollar question. Shot in the dark, like in May is when I Googled first Dirks' tour manager. Find my little channel to him. Couldn't find his direct email. So I hit up their management company and somehow it got in his hands. And then he emailed me about a month later directly. And he was like, let's chat about this idea. Like, let me know what you have in mind. And I was like, oh my God, this is going to happen. And then I told him, I was like, I'm kind of up for anything that you want. Like, I didn't expect to be on stage, like maybe something cool backstage. And then he called me up and was like, yeah, man, I talked to Dirks and he's about it. He wants to do this. And then he's like, I'm surprised, man. I haven't seen him do this in over like 8 years for anyone like outside their crew. And I was like, that is amazing. It's like awesome to hear.
Were there any hiccups that Dominic on the way? I know planning my proposal, it was like there were so many moving pieces. So
yeah, this is a good one for you. So I snuck over to the concert early to grab these. The tour manager left us some like VIP or upgraded passes.
Okay.
So we fight through the crowd. It's mobbed everywhere. We get to the right side of the stage and the Windy City Smokeout workers are like, no, you can't get through here with those. Those don't work here. I'm like, oh, Jesus.
Oh, no.
There we go. So then we had to hook all the way around the concert. And then finally they grabbed an actual like manager over there that kind of knew what was going on or knew what he was talking about. And he's like, yes, they can get through here. And then we finally made it to the pit, and then the security.
You're like, we're not even going to be able to get to the stage, let alone.
No, it was hard.
It's becoming crunch time.
Oh, I love it. Well, congratulations, and I'm so happy for you guys, and I can't wait to see you in Mexico for the wedding.
Yes, you are invited.
Thanks so much. Thank you.